All right, guys, today we're taking a look at Grind Session. I'm going to be at Templeton. This game is probably one of the best PlayStation skateboarding games that there ever was. I reviewed it a while ago. It was one of the first things I did on my channel, and so the production value, not so great. The audio isn't very good. I'm just talking into the camera's normal mic. It's got a lot of technical issues, but I really wanted to cover this game again because I think it really deserves it. So I'm going to talk through the way that it works a little bit. I'm playing it on an emulator for the sake of recording, so it looks a little bit sharper than it actually does, but that's just for simplicity's sake. So some of the things you have to do in the levels, there's things to collect and there's these lines you have to hit. So if you hit R2, you can see the lines. And the color of the line shows you how many extra seconds you get. So this is a big one, which I just bailed. The controls are gonna take a little getting used to. Like, you don't hit back to slow down. You kind of just have to turn around full speed. Which can get a little bit difficult. So, all right, I gotta do that. I have to hit these boom boxes. And there is a gap right up here that I can try to do. All right, one cool thing about this game is that it kind of locks you onto the plane of the ground you're above. So you don't really have to drop into a ramp. You can just kind of ollie at it and your character will even out. Which is pretty cool. So I've played this level quite a few times. I expect I'll do fairly well on it. Of course, now that I've said that, I won't. The grinding feels a little bit different in this game. Like, if you don't hold down triangle, the controls are basically the same as Tony Hawk, with a few differences I'll get to, but if you don't hold down the grind button, you will pop off after a second. Like, it doesn't instantly land, but it will ruin your grind. It's kind of weird. All right. Let's see if I can get this gap. My balance stat is terrible. All right. So there is... Oh, man. There is one gap that's really hard to find on this one. It's not difficult to do, but it's really out of the way. I really need to get this one, though. Come on, come on. All right, that was only worth 5 seconds, dang it. Better hurry up. Kind of stuck in switch stance here. I think that's messing with me, too. Okay, in this disgusting meat locker, or whatever this is. And then the last boombox and gap is up here. All right, so the goal of the levels, okay, I got 10 out of 10 of the gaps. I'm not sure if I got all the boomboxes or not. The goal of the levels, I'll show you, is to get a score, to get the boomboxes or whatever the destructible thing in that level is, and the technical lines, which are the gaps. So I maxed out that level, 40 points. Okay, and I get to pick some new tricks, which is kind of cool. I'm gonna do the front side kickflip varial, which of course is a hard flip, although the game has a hard flip and it's just like a pop shove it. I earned 3 of them. Okay, continue. Oh, and I also got a key. For maxing out the level, you get a key, and at the end, there's a giant mansion, and the keys will unlock different rooms, which is pretty cool. So I can either go to one of the other levels, or I can do this photo shoot, and I'm going to show you that. So when you max out a level, you get this photo shoot option, and you basically have to get a high score at a certain spot, which is a good way to kind of mix it up. Okay, 1,000 points in one trick. Let's see. There we go. Really easy, first level. But it unlocks an actual photo of your pro. So you could go look at those, and they're from ads and all. Yeah, there you go. So that's pretty cool. All right, so let's talk about the way the challenges work a little bit. Getting the destructibles and the gaps, if you restart the level, you have to get them again. It's basically like if you can get all 10 at once, that's worth some points. But, man. Let me restart. But if you get five of them, let's say I got five of them right now and I went back and got the other five. Man, why can't I ollie right there? It wouldn't count as getting all 10. You have to actually get all 10 at once. I don't know why I can't do that. I'm having some trouble. Ed. See how that hard flip looks. Oh, that was laggy. That's the emulator, though. That's not the game. So sometimes, all right, I'm just gonna restart. I'm having trouble with that gap. Let's just see what else I can do. I replayed that first level before starting recording just to make sure I remembered how to play the game. So I had a little bit of an advantage having recently played it. This level, I don't really remember quite so well. Come on. Some of the gaps you can do as a line and not... Come on, I'm doing terrible on this level. I always end up riding switch. Doesn't matter what stance my skater is, I will always be stuck in switch. Wow, this is terrible. Some of these gaps you can do it as a line instead of a combo. It's just, so you see the number one and the number two. As long as I hit them both, it would usually count. There's a trash can here. I can't slow down. Come on. Okay, if you hit circle, you can come to a dead stop. All right, good. What else do we have here? There is a whole underground area to this level. Ugh. Man. I don't remember if your stats can upgrade at all. I didn't know Ed Templeton was so terrible at grinds. Usually play as Daewon Song, but I have a save game for that on here, so figured I would restart. Well, that counted good. I wasn't really sure. Okay. Let's go down into the subway area. There's a gap right here. Okay, there's a gap right here. Trash can. So, if you haven't played this game, I would definitely recommend it. It's cheap, you know, like most old PlayStation games. Oh, my time. Oh, I wasn't even paying attention. Good enough. Let me just continue. Like most old PlayStation games, only a couple bucks. And this one, it has a lot of different things that hadn't really been developed yet. So like in Tony Hawk, this came out, I think, after Tony Hawk 1, and it has manuals, technically, but not really. Let me see if I can do one. I don't remember the control for it. Yeah, there you go. So if you hit down, down, triangle, you'll do a manual, but there's no balance, and it's just kind of like it takes the amount of time that it takes, and then it's done. So it's kind of a pointless thing. I really need to start over, waste some time here. It doesn't really do anything as far as score, like linking things together. You can't link anything together with it. But it's there. This was one of the first games to have manuals in it. It's just that it isn't really a functional manual. Okay, let's see. I thought about doing a video before of like the top five Burnside representations in a video game. But I would kind of have to go there and kind of tell which one is the best. So I remember this level can be kind of tough. There's an ad for Deka right there, which was only in business for a little while. Ah, come on, I didn't get that gap. So that really dates the game. Oh yeah, I just did a boneless. You can do a boneless, but it is like an air trick. You can also do a nollie, I think, up, there you go. You can do a nollie, which isn't really a nollie, because it's, cool, I got something there. because it's just like a flip trick that you can do. But that was kind of the state of the art at the time. Okay. How do I grind that? I really wish I could slow down. You get used to in Tony Hawk when you can just, is that not far enough? Okay. You get used to in Tony Hawk where you can just stop and then instantly be at full speed. Come on, come on, come on. Man. Got this. Ugh, can't see anything. So you two get the old PlayStation era camera issues. Okay. That was a very unsuccessful run. He seems excited about it though. I unlocked a level. You know what? Let me just keep on going. I don't think I'm going to play through the whole game here, so I might as well just give you a good taste of what all the levels are like. Hopefully I'll do a little better. Slam City Jam. Okay, competition. Slam City Jam used to be so big at the time. Alright, let's see what I have to do. I think there's like a, street section. Okay, I can knock over the barrels. And then there's vert. Is there a best trick too? I don't really remember. Oh yeah, so I was saying before, like you can, you will kind of lock into the level of the ground that you're about to land on. So if you air out of a quarter pipe, it's usually not a big deal, which is pretty cool. Alright, let's see. What else do I have here? I should have remembered what all those tricks I unlocked were. I think you can skate vert in the street part. Oh, okay. So right now I have my special meter, whatever this game calls it. And you spin much faster with that. It really helps. It doesn't last forever, though. It's a manual back, what the game calls it. Kind of funny. All right, let's see if I can get this. Ugh. Head's balance is just terrible. I thought it'd be pretty good. Something about this game, I don't know why, but during the competitions, it's like such pressure to do all your tricks. Seems like it's a lot harder than it should be. Alright, I think I'm doing okay. It's only the first competition. I don't think I need to worry too much. Let's see, how did I do? Second place, okay, good enough. Okay. So there's a guy in this game called Pigpen, which I'm not familiar with. I think he was like a local guy around Burnside area or something. And he's in the game. And his stance is listed as irregular, which I was so confused by back in the day. I thought this was like some kind of different stance that nobody else had. I used to have a friend. Man, that speed up really messes with me sometimes. I used to have a friend in high school who he kind of claimed he had an irregular stance. He would push and ride around and stuff and goofy, but he would only do tricks regular. And so I thought that that's what that meant. But he's just goofy. But he just thought it'd be funny to list himself as irregular. Okay, how am I doing? Let's see. Ugh, come on. This game, okay, so the best trick can make or break your run, your competition aspirations, because you get one chance. So if you get a little too greedy, and you bail your trick, you might lose the whole competition. So it all kind of adds up. You see the scores, they all add up into one total, just flat. So the best trick is only going to be worth a few thousand points. If I lose, it looks like I'll still be in second in this case, and I would have to get like 11,000 points with this one combo to get first, which I don't think is going to happen. But let's see what I can do here. All right. So there you go. I got nothing. But that's okay. Let's go for a rocket grab. London. London's a tough one. I think I said I got a photo shoot. Yeah, let me do the photo shoot. Those are kind of fun. This one, there's like a secret area in the back of the level. And you can get to it during the street run. But you kind of waste time going through hallways and stuff. And it's back here. So you get to play it anyway. But all right, let's see. Ooh, well, there goes my chance. So what I'm trying to do is grind on the on that up there, the light rail or whatever that is. No. Come on. There we go. Let's see. Nope. So you do kind of come to miss. Why didn't that come? You do kind of come to miss the combo ability of the Tony Hawk games. Okay, that's interesting. So I'm actually grinding in a perfect circle, although the land back in a grind, Ed, you frickin' guy. Do it. I don't know if I can get a 4,000 point air on its own. No, I don't know if that's possible. So I have 25 seconds. Can I do like a straight air and get some speed? Does that count? Okay. Wait, my 540 didn't count? No, I did. Nope. I remember this one being weirdly difficult. It's because you can't do anything else. So I don't have the points, the stats to get all the way up there first try. So what am I supposed to do? All right, let's just do a really long grind. How's that sound? Sounds like I'm not gonna make it to 4,000. Especially with a 50-50. Come on, I hit some buttons there. Why didn't I do anything? If you can hear my dog, I apologize for that. He is going to town on a bone. You know what? Forget this. Yeah, he's going to town on a bone over there. I'm not sure if it's picking up on the mic or not. Okay. PlayStation Park is really hard. You see, I've only really played four levels, and yet I can already be at the end of the game almost. Which is a bit too soon. You can really get yourself too far. Like the PlayStation Park, if I try to do that right away, it's really tough. This level is also really tough because it's so big. It's actually kind of giant for a PlayStation game. And it's also got some difficult situations you can get into where you have to kind of go back, but you have to like climb up a building. Come on, stop. I really wish you could hold back to slow down. It's taking a lot of getting used to. All right, so I know there's something to do here. All right, cool. Yeah, to try to get all the technical lines in this level in one run is really hard. So you're not gonna see me do that today, but I did do it before. I don't remember where they all are. It's one of the problems. You can definitely check out my review to see some more of that kind of stuff. Okay. There is also the skater's eye mode where you actually come to a stop and you can look around, which helps a little bit, but it wastes too much time in an actual run. Come on, balance, Ed. There we go. 5 seconds. Come on. This door open. Cool. All right, so some of these gaps were really, really hard. Stupidly hard. I talked about that in the review as well. I remember there's this one here. It doesn't want to work. So you can hear the little ka-ching sound whenever I do land on one. Okay. I was going to say, you didn't hear it when I went over the first one, even though I touched it. So I thought that it wasn't going to work. But cool, yeah. was not expecting to get that one. That was one of the tough ones. Okay, got five of those. Let's see. Hold it. All right, man, killing it. So some of the other barriers, for example, are in the beginning, I went down into that parking structure, but there are some that are actually on the other building, and I would have had to gap over to it. So I kind of... it would be kind of impossible for me to get all the way back there and do those. I'm going to hit this one again. I unlocked Detroit. It's kind of cool. I didn't mean to hit that. Let's retry. Okay. So. Okay. Yeah, we can get over here. Some of these gaps get to be really hard. Because, like I said, you don't really upgrade your stats at all. Cool. So if your character isn't good at something, he's just not good at it. Alright. Come on, get off of this rail. Okay. Oh, yeah, this... Okay, so I have to gap all the way over to that other building. But the only way I'm going to do it is if I have my special meter, which sometimes feels really slow. So I'm kind of on a time crunch here because there's so much more I have to do. And yet I have to sit here and build my special. Okay. Now we'll see if that's even enough. Nope. So that gap, you have to do it to be successful at all in the level, but it's really tough. So what I'm just going to try to do, I guess, is get the pro score or whatever it calls it, if I can. One cool thing about the grinds, I forgot to mention, is that there's only really like an up and down version of every grind. So to do a tail slide or a blunt slide, you have to turn sideways and then hit down. So it's the same control as a 5-0. Man, I didn't... Oh, I did a little bit better on the points. Let me give that one more try. And so it kind of is a bit more natural, almost like skate. You know, like you have to turn your body and then just lean in one direction or the other, and it's not really about hitting a combination, really. So I thought that was pretty cool. Okay, 5 seconds will always help. Let's see. I'm just gonna try it. I think I got some decent speed. Ugh. Yeah, so I remember having some really frustrating moments working on that. But it's not impossible. Okay, come on. Come on, Ed. Get up there. It's only 8 feet tall. Why can't you ollie up on that? Man, my balance is terrible. It's really messing with me. So yeah, I have, oh, come on. I have hard flips. I don't remember how to do it. Whatever. There's my hard flip. Doesn't it look exactly like a pop shove it? And then here's an actual hard flip. Oh, 90s. Alright. Oh, boneless out of a blunt slide. I've never seen that before. Okay, whatever. Time to move on. Got some pro points. Alright, let's see what else. I'm gonna go to PlayStation Park. I thought it said I got Detroit. Did it lie to me? Okay. This level has got some pretty tough gaps, but there's also a lot of really cool ones where it kind of like launches you like a rail that kind of throws you like a pole jam almost and sends you flying. So one of the best things about this game, which I'm not really going to be able to get into here, is just trying to optimize your run so that you get all of it. You know, like you have to hit this gap in one try because next you got to go over here and you have to hit this one. But, oh, you should probably do this red one first because it gives you the extra, the most extra time and all that kind of stuff, which is pretty cool. Dang it. I keep trying to do like a wall ride up, you know, like Tony Hawk style. It's not going to work. Oh, that was one. Okay, cool. One here. Yeah, so there's a lot of strategy you can do, like what kind of are you going to try to hit as many as possible to build time? Are you going to try to do the hard one first to get it out of the way? All that kind of stuff. One thing that sucks though, like I had to use that kicker. Boom, it's gone. So if I accidentally knocked it over before I got that gap, I wouldn't be able to get it. There's a couple little things like that. Like they try to make it more destructible for the sake of getting like extra points for vandalism, you know, but it can kind of mess with you too. So you can kind of do a spine transfer, but that wasn't in Tony Hawk until Tony Hawk 4. Okay, what else we got? Okay, yeah, I think I could hit that kicker. Okay, let me try to get this game. I really like the way the vert feels in this game. No, I can't. Because the way the camera kind of flattens out, like you kind of spin flat even though you're on vert, it kind of feels, I think, a bit more natural. Like, come on. It's more kind of feels like you're on a board instead of flying in the air. I don't know. It's kind of hard to explain, but just like the way that it looks and feels. Okay, I got 8 of the gaps. Where, I remember, one is up here. So yeah, I can't knock that kicker over. This is one of the cool ones. Ugh, you have to land back on the rail. I couldn't really help that I didn't do that. Come on, Ed, where's your pop? Ugh, well, there goes that one. There we go. All right, I got that one. So I got 9 out of 10. I could theoretically get that one if I hadn't knocked over that kicker. Again, there's no way to wall ride up to it. You can try to bone this, but it's not going to actually give you any extra height or anything. So there goes my run. All right, let's just try to get some points while we're here. This game has a pretty nice tray flip, too. I always try to pay attention to how good they do those. Oh, I got a lot of the points. Cool. You know what? I actually did pretty well at that one. That's one of the tougher levels, usually. Okay, let's do Detroit. Okay, I always enjoy playing in Detroit in video games because I used to work downtown in the city, and it's always interesting to see what people think it's like. So according to this game, there's like lots of flaming pipes that are just like shooting out chemicals and death all the time. Which I wouldn't say is inaccurate, but it's not all that common. Okay, so some of these gaps are really tough. There we go. So I have to kind of gap 90 degrees to go between those, and it's kind of weird. So yeah, I hit that valve and then just fire starts shooting out of it. Yeah, this one is definitely one of the tougher levels. So I might have to go do some of the other levels to get more points instead of trying to do this one again. There we go. So you do kind of like lock onto stuff. I was sort of helped out magnetically a little bit right there, it seemed like. Okay, so there's some weird like vert gaps and stuff you have to do in this one that don't work all that well. Or this one even, I'm not really even sure. It's like I have to use those stairs like a kicker, but you can't actually ride up them. So this gap, you kind of have to do backward, I think. Kind of weird. Alright, what you got? Okay, that counted, even though I didn't really do it. Okay, now if I go in here, there's a gap. Wrong way. And I'm running out of time. So imagine trying to hit 10 of these gaps in one run. Can be crazy hard. Come on. Lock into that. Ed. Alright. Cool. Alright. Is that a gap on its own? That's just one rail. Okay. There's one over here that's really hard. Two. Let's see. Because you have to get the speed. Oh, well, there goes my time. You have to have the perfect amount of speed and everything. I'm gonna not play this with this one because it's too hard. But I would like to show you this one. I need two more respect. Let's go here and just get some points. Pro points begin at 10,000. It doesn't say how many you actually need, but that's okay. We'll figure it out. Take another quick shot at hitting this gap, too. Oh, did I do it? Okay, well, there you go. I'm not going to bother with all the gaps because it'll be too hard to get two extra points. I need to just work on my... There, I'm at 20. I probably have the full score right now, actually. So it's 10,000 where the pro points start. Maybe it's an additional 10,000. I'm not really sure. Well, maybe I'll do some gaps then. Come on, Ed. See, I'm always in switch when I don't want to be. The fact that it had a meter for grind balance was actually kind of a new thing as well. I think Tony Hawk 1 and 2, there's not a meter except for manuals. Come on. So this game did actually do some new stuff. I think Grind Session 2, if it had ever come out, would have been one of the best games ever made. Best skateboarding games, at least. Because there's a lot of really solid ideas here that just didn't have time to really get finished. Man, I'm not getting it this time. I don't know. I think it's safe to say I have enough points, though. So let's exit the level. Let's see what happens. What? It didn't count any of them. Of course it didn't. I had to just run out the clock. Speaking of running out the clock, I've been playing this game for over a half hour. At this point, I would love to show you the final level. There is the whole mansion and everything, and maybe I'll have to show that. I'm thinking about maybe doing like a part two. So I take this playthrough, I'll go back and try to like finish it and show you like, you know, trying to do all of these separate gaps all at once and all that kind of stuff. It might be kind of cool, because this game is a lot of fun, and I'm always happy for an excuse to play it some more. But it's just too bad I already did the review. At some point, I think after like X amount of years, like 4 or 5 years, I think my old videos will be fair game. Because when I made this review, I had maybe a couple hundred subscribers at most. And I would say the vast majority of you guys have not seen it. So at what point is it safe for me to redo something? How did that count? All right. At what point is it fair for me to redo something without it just being like a rehash? I'm not really sure. I'm trying to figure out some of that kind of stuff for the channel. Alright, one of the gaps is right here. Another gap is right there. Cool. It's kind of weird, like, the way that the nollie is a flip trick, but you can only do it once, as if it kind of knows that it's not really a flip trick. It's really weird. did it count that first one? One other kind of cool thing about this game that you have to get used to is the fact that it kind of locks you in to your spins a little bit. So like if you spin like maybe like a little bit more than 90 degrees, it'll just kind of slowly pull you over so that you land straight, which is kind of nice. There's like less cheap accidental bails because of that. So I think that's kind of nice. It can be difficult though, like when you're trying to specifically do a sideways grind, you know, tail slide or whatever. It's sometimes really difficult to make it. No, I'm not gonna make it. It might be kind of difficult to do that on purpose because you'll turn sideways and then snap back in the air. It's kind of a weird feeling that's kind of tough to explain. I don't really want tricks that are gonna end me in weird angles here. Okay. Let me show you the last level. This one can get tough. There's what is it that you have to do? There's like a trick mode where you have to do a certain list of tricks, which is not what I'm doing right now. I don't remember how you get to that. And it's so hard. Stuff pops up on the screen. You have to do like a kickflip to no slide to board slide, and you have to just do it all. And it's so hard. But yeah, there's definitely some good challenge to this game. I know I've gotten to the last level without much difficulty, but I haven't really seen a lot of it. You know, a lot of the levels I didn't truly explore because I haven't been looking for all the gaps, that kind of thing. So there is a lot more to see in this game that I think is worth your time to check out. Okay. I should have, trying to do like a Tony Hawk Underground sticker slap or something on that to turn around. I've been playing a lot of those games lately to try to do reviews. The only thing about some of the more recent Tony Hawk games, like, you know, PS2 era and further, is that they are big. They take a while. So it's kind of tough to get them all done for the channel. Like, it took me, I'm not even sure how long in real time to play Tony Hawk Underground. I'm not talking about, like, my save game length time, but, like, the amount of real time weeks it took me just to find enough time to beat it. So it sucks because I want to be really thorough, and I just can't be. I can't 100% do those games anymore. The first few ones, like, you know, Tony Hawk 1, 2, and 3, it's not so bad, and I could probably get away with it, but it's one of the things that I'm worried about moving forward with the channel. That's why I've been playing some games like this. I want to start playing some more on the original Nintendo, that kind of thing, because they're small enough that I can reasonably beat them. If I were to try to review Skate, which I will, I see all the comments, I will. One of the things about that game is that it will take me like a month, you know? And if I'm gonna play a game for a month, then I have to have a lot of other stuff built up that I can post during that month. And then it only goes up from there. There's Skate 2 and 3, and then whatever else, which kind of sucks. Man, I'm really blowing it at this run here. Hopefully I do okay. That's kind of cool. I thought that was kind of a new thing, like the where it measures your height. Like there's a magnet on your board and it measures it. Anyway, let's see how I did. Second place, okay. Best trick, high risk. Again, I'm in a situation where I'll still get second even if I bail. That was never the case in my other playthroughs. So again, I can't, there we go. I was gonna say, I can't get too greedy, and then I bailed. You got 1,000 points for that? I'm not sure why. It doesn't really make any difference, but there you go. You have beaten the game. You unlocked a photo shoot. So that's how I'll finish this off. I'll do one more photo shoot. Oh, we get to watch my video. I'm Ed Templeton, so I'm not sure what I'm seeing. I don't remember. Oh, it's just the credits video. Okay. You do unlock some different types of videos throughout the game. I hit skip, and now it's just... There we go. Oh, the mansion. Okay, we'll see. I guess I'll show you this part instead of a photo shoot. Look at that. Look at that limo. It's such a weird shape. So this is kind of a cool bonus thing that they did, because you don't really know about it until... I mean, you can see that there are keys, but you don't really know what you're doing until you actually beat the game. And it really gives you an incentive to go back and finish it, which I think is pretty cool. So this is the mansion. I'm just going to skip ahead. There's different rooms, different wings, and all that stuff that are different sorts of areas. Okay, so I have the east wing. And then you can get the different keys, and once you're inside, you can collect coins. And if you get all those coins, you unlock an extra character who's like a guru or something like that. So you see, I'm stuck in this room right now. But you can do like a long line all the way through this giant level. If you were to get them all. So there's a coin up there. Let's see if I can grab that. Right there, that glowing coin. I don't remember how many there are. There's like one in each level you have to get. One in each area of the mansion, I mean. And then you'll unlock him. But that's kind of what I'm talking about with the vert. Like the camera angle kind of looks down on the ramp. And I think it feels a lot more natural than being truly vertical like you are in other games. All right. Well, whether I get that coin or not doesn't really matter. I'm gonna have to play it some more later anyway. But as of right now, that's it for this game. It's a really good one. Hey, I got it. It's a really good game, and I strongly suggest you check it out. Don't forget that you can play PS1 games on PS2 or PS3. I think PS4 as well. A lot of people don't even know that, so you can pick up this game for a couple bucks and try it out. It's definitely worth it, especially if you have any kind of nostalgia for this time period in gaming or in skateboarding. It's got Daewon Song on the cover, he's in the game, it's just such a cool game. So I strongly suggest this one. You can watch my review, just be patient with microphone quality and things like that. But until next time, this was Grind Session, and I will see you soon in another video. Thanks for watching.